Assalamu alaikum viewers. So today's lecture is about flow injection analysis or FIA analysis. The links of PDF files used in this video are given in the description. So this is the part one of this lecture series. So the flow injection analysis is used in those methods where we measure a time dependent signal. So in chemistry, if we see that there are two types of time dependent signals which are most commonly used, such as chemical kinetic methods, and second is the radiochemical methods. So in this technique, we inject the sample into a flowing carrier stream that give rise to a transient signal at a detector. Because the shape of this transient signal depends on the physical and chemical kinetic process occurring in the carrier stream during the time between the injection and detection. So that is why we have included flow injection analysis in detail in this lecture. Flow injection analysis was developed in mid-1970s and it is a highly efficient technique for the automated analysis of the samples. For example, unlike centrifugal analyzers where the samples are limited by the number of transfer disk size, FIA allows for the rapid sequential analysis of unlimited number of samples. So FIA is one of the examples of continuous flow analyzer in which we sequentially introduce samples at regular intervals into a liquid carrier stream and that transports them to the detector. A schematic diagram of the basic concepts of flow injection analysis has been shown in this figure. The reagent serving as the carrier is stored in a reagent reservoir, and a propelling unit maintains a constant flow of the carrier through a system of tubing that comprises the transport system. We inject our sample directly into the flowing carrier stream where it travels through one or more mixing or reacting zones before reaching the detector or flow cell. So this is the simplest diagram or design for the flow injection analyzer, consisting of a single channel and one reagent reservoir. Multiple channel instruments that merge together separate channels, each introducing a new reagent into the carrier stream, are also possible. So in the next part, we will discuss the FIA instrumentation in detail. So in this diagram, actually, we have explained the effect of dispersion on the shape of a sample's flow profile at different times during our flow injection analysis. So if we see here in this position, when we first inject a sample into the carrier stream, it has a rectangular flow profile of width W as shown in figure. As the sample moves through the mixing and reaction zone, the width of its flow profile increases as the sample disperses into the carrier stream. Now this dispersion results from two processes. One process is called the convection, which is due to the flow of a carrier stream, and diffusion due to the concentration gradient between the sample and the carrier stream. So convection occurs by the laminar flow. The linear velocity of the sample at the tube's wall is zero, but the sample at the center of the tube moves with the linear velocity twice that of a carrier stream. That result is the parabolic flow profile as shown in figure B. So the flat profile has been changed into a parabolic flow profile. So convection is the primary means of dispersion in the first few seconds or in the first few instants when the sample is injected. The second contributor to the sample dispersion is diffusion due to the concentration gradient between the sample and the carrier stream. As shown in figure here, that this is the direction of carrier stream's flow, and the diffusion occurs by two ways. It may occur axial diffusion, which is parallel to the flow, and the second diffusion phenomena is the radial diffusion, and this diffusion is actually the perpendicular to the direction in which the carrier stream is moving. So only the radial diffusion is important in flow injection analysis. Radial diffusion decreases the sample's linear velocity at the center of the tubing, while the sample at the edges of the tubing experience an increase in velocity. So diffusion helps to maintain the integrity of the sample's flow, as we have shown here. So it prevents the sample in the carrier stream from dispersing into one another. So both convection and diffusion make significant contribute towards the dispersion from approximately 3 to 20 seconds after the sample's injection. So this is the normal time scale for flow injection analysis. After approximately 25 seconds, diffusion remains the only significant contributor to the dispersion of the sample. So this will result in a flow profile similar to as shown here in figure D. So in this diagram, we have actually explained the FIA gram, or this is actually the plot of detector signal as a function of time. So this figure represents a typical FIA gram, and it is for that condition in which both convection and diffusion contributes to the sample dispersion. As shown in figure, there are several parameters for characterizing the sample FIA gram. So two parameters define the time for the sample to move from the injector to the detector. So first, this is the TA, and this time is called as the travel time, and it is the time between the sample's injection and the arrival of its leading edge at the detector. Whereas second parameter is the residence time, which is represented here by a capital T, and it is the time required to obtain the maximum signal. So the difference between the travel time and the residence time is actually represented by a small t with dash, and this approaches to zero when convection is the only primary means of dispersion, whereas this time increases its value as the contribution from diffusion becomes important. So apart from travel time and the residence time, there are certain other parameters also. The time required for the sample to pass through the detector's flow cell and for the signal to return to the baseline is also described by two parameters. The baseline to baseline time, which is represented by del t, and this is the time between the arrival of sample's leading edge to the departure of its trailing edge. The elapsed time between the maximum signal and its return to the baseline is the return time, which is represented here by capital T dash. The final characteristic parameter of this FIA gram is the sample's peak height, and this peak height is represented by H. As we have described the six parameters, and the most important are the peak height and return time. Peak height is important because it is directly or indirectly related to the analyte concentration, and the sensitivity of an FIA method therefore is determined by the peak height. Second important parameter is the return time. That is important because it determines the frequency with which we inject samples. For example, here in this figure, we have shown a continuous two FIA grams. So if we inject a second sample at a time T dash after the injecting the first sample, there is a little overlap of the two FIA curves. So by injecting samples at the intervals of T time dash, we obtain the maximum possible sampling rate. So peak height and return times are influenced by the dispersion of the sample's profile and by the physical and chemical properties of the flow injection system. Physical parameters affecting height and the T dash include the volume of the sample we inject, the flow rate, the length, diameter, and geometry of the mixing and reacting zones, and the presence of mixing points between the separate channels merged together. The kinetics of any chemical reaction between the sample and the reagents in the carrier stream also influence the peak height and return time. So in any FIA gram, we mainly focus on these two parameters, which is the peak height and the return time of the sample. The basic components of a flow injection analyzer are shown in figure. And so first of all, we notice here a pump, which is used for propelling the carrier stream and a reagent stream. Then a means for injecting the sample into the carrier stream. And then third is the detector, which is used for monitoring the composition of the carrier stream. Connecting these units is a transport system that brings together separate channels and provide time for the sample to mix with the carrier stream and to react with the reagent stream. So here we are seeing here, there are two mixing and reaction coils. We can also incorporate separation modules in this transport system. So this particular configuration has actually two channels. One is used for carrier stream and other is for the reagent line. So the final flow of all these things, including the sample, including our reagent line and including our carrier line, and after reacting here in these two places, the final flow of these solvents is moved towards the detector, and where we obtain the signal in the form of a FIA gram. The detailed discussion about working principle of this pump, the carrier stream, the injectors and the reaction and mixing coils, these particular components are explained in detail in the next lecture. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.